In this video, we study integer linear programs or short ILPs and how to solve them using linear relaxation. Recall the original definition of an LP. We have an objective to maximize while satisfying the given constraints. Most importantly, our variables can be fractional values. However, in an integer linear program, we restrict the variables to be integers. In many combinatorial problems, we further restrict the variables to just two values, 0 or 1. They are then called indicator variables. We call these programs binary ILPs. There exist also other variants of the standard linear programming, such as mixed integer linear programming that can use both integer and continuous variables, or quadratic programming that relaxes the objective constraint. However, in this video, we only focus on the ILP and specifically on binary ILPs. Recall the knapsack problem where we have capacity C and N items. Each item has a value V and a weight W. We try to maximize the value of the selected items with regards to our weight limit C. How could we formulate this as an integer linear program? This is one possible solution. We can use indicator variables for each item to encode if we select the item or not. The value of the selected items is equal to the sum of each item times its indicator variable. Note that the variable is 1 if we take the item and 0 if we do not take the item. Therefore, the sum corresponds exactly to the value of the selected items. At last, we can write down the total weight of all selected items as the sum of the weight of each item times its indicator variable being less or equal to the weight limit C. Unfortunately, unlike LPs, no efficient algorithm for solving ILPs is known. One possible strategy is relaxing our integer constraints for the variables. Instead of forcing them to be either 0 or 1, we relax the variable to be in the interval between 0 and 1. Then we can use the simplex algorithm to solve the LP and afterwards round the variables to either 0 or 1, according to the nearest feasible point. We call this the linear relaxation. Unfortunately, there is no guarantee that a linear relaxation finds the optimum. Moreover, sometimes the found solution can even be arbitrarily bad. Let us visualize what is going wrong when we relax the integer problem. The white points represent all integer points we could consider for the ILP. The orange points are the feasible points of the ILP. Furthermore, the optimal points are all marked with green. When we relax the variables to be in the unit interval, we also consider all fractional values. The optimum that we find for the relaxed LP might have fractional values. To get a feasible solution, we have to round the variables. But in this process, we lose the optimality guarantees of our search. It could be that rounding the found solution gives the right answer. However, we could also end up at an infeasible point for the integer version of the LP. Even if we are able to round to the closest feasible point, we might end up at a node that is no longer optimal. However, for some specific types of problems, we are guaranteed that we can always find the right answer using linear relaxation. One of these tasks is the assignment problem. In the assignment problem, we are given a list of customers and a list of cabs. For each cab, we know how long the travel time is to each customer. We want to match the cabs to the customers in order to minimize the total waiting time. How could we find the solution using integer linear programming? This is one possible solution. We introduce an indicator variable for each arrow between a customer I and a cab J. This encodes if cab J will pick up customer I. Each cab can pick up at most one passenger. Therefore, the sum of all outgoing arrows can be at most one. Each passenger must be picked up by one cab. So the sum of all incoming arrows must be exactly one. The total travel time is then equal to the sum of the times it takes for the cab to get to the passenger multiplied with the corresponding indicator variable. This describes the objective and completes our ILP. In this problem, the constraint matrix is totally unimodular, meaning that the determinant of each submatrix is either minus 1, 0 or 1. This is a non-trivial property to check and usually hard to determine. However, for a certain class of tasks that includes the assignment problem, the matrices are known to be totally unimodular. Whenever this is the case, we are guaranteed that the linear relaxation will give us the correct answer. Therefore, we can apply linear relaxation and solve the assignment problem. In other words, just solving this linear program is guaranteed to give us a solution where every indicator variable is either 0 or 1. Let us summarize what we have seen in this video. We started by introducing integer linear programs in order to solve discrete tasks that require the solutions to be integral instead of fractional. If we only allow indicator variables, we call it a binary ILP. Unfortunately, we cannot directly solve ILPs efficiently. One approach is to relax the integrality constraint of the variables and only require them to be between 0 and 1. Now we can solve the relaxed version using linear programming. The found solution is either already integral, or we have to round them to whole numbers. In general, the rounding strategy does not guarantee us a good solution. However, for some specific tasks, such as the assignment problem, linear relaxation directly computes the optimal solution that has integral variables. Thank you for watching this video.